And next, we're going to talk about the relationship between consumption, savings, and our income. Recall that at the intersection between the 45-degree line and our consumption schedule, that means, hey, our disposable income is exactly equal to our consumption. And therefore, if you are spending your entire disposable income, that means how much is your saving? Your saving is zero. Now on the right-hand side, we have our saving schedule. So if your disposable income is DI1 and you spend the entire paycheck, that means your saving is exactly zero. And next, suppose you're on the right-hand side of the 45-degree line, meaning your disposable income is higher than your consumption. So here on the right-hand side, we can see our disposable income is DI2, but our consumption is only C2. So your saving is positive. In fact, your saving is exactly equal to that distance. So we call that S2. So your saving is positive when your disposable income is DI2. Now, what happens if you're on the point F? So F is on the consumption schedule at the left-hand side of the 45-degree line. So it is a left-hand side, so you know that your consumption C3 is greater than your disposable income DI3. Therefore, your saving and your saving is equal to negative S3. So on the right-hand side, you have the saving, you find the point, and you connect the three points, you get your saving schedule. So you know that when your disposable income is DI3, your saving is negative. Here is our saving schedule. S is equal to negative A plus MPS times DI, and A is our autonomous consumption, which we mentioned before. MPS is our marginal propensity to save, and that is also equal to the slope of our saving schedule. How do we know that? Here is our slope, change in saving divided by change in disposable income, and that's exactly the definition of MPS. And finally, if your saving is positive, then, well, we have savings. If your saving is negative, below zero, then you're dissaving. This slide is only for your information to show you how I get my saving schedule in case you're interested in the calculation. So here, our consumption is equal to autonomous consumption A plus MPC times disposable income. But I also know that, hey, saving is equal to disposable income minus consumption. And the next step, I am going to substituting my consumption with A plus MPC times DI. And the rest will be just some algebraic manipulation. Eventually, you are going to get your saving is equal to negative autonomous consumption plus MPS times disposable income.